So, in a previous lecture, we have learnt about applications of equilibrium constant, and now in this lecture we will discuss about a relationship between equilibrium constant K, reaction quotient Q, Gibbs free energy capital G, and factors affecting equilibria. Now, relationship between equilibrium constant K, reaction quotient Q, and Gibbs energy, that is capital G. The value of Kc for a reaction does not depend on the rate of the reaction. However, it is directly related to the thermodynamics of the reaction and in a particular to the change in Gibbs energy, that is delta G. If delta G is negative, then the reaction is spontaneous and proceed in the forward direction. If delta G is positive, then the reaction is considered non-spontaneous. Instead, as reverse reaction would have a negative delta G. The products of the forward reaction shall be converted to the reactants. If delta G is 0, reaction has achieved equilibrium. At this point, there is no longer any free energy left to derive the reaction. A mathematical expression for this thermodynamic view of equilibrium can be described by the following equation. Delta G is equal to delta G naught, that is standard Gibbs free energy, plus RT ln Q. This equation is 1. Here, delta G naught standard is standard Gibbs energy. At equilibrium, when delta G is 0 and Q is equal to Kc, the equation first becomes delta G is equal to delta G naught plus RT ln K is equal to 0. So, delta G naught is equal to minus RT ln K. This is equation second. We can derive the value of ln K. Ln K is equal to minus delta G naught divided by RT. Taking anti log of both sides, we get K is equal to e to the power minus delta G naught by RT. That is equation third. Hence, using the equation third, the reaction spontaneity can be interpreted in the terms of delta G standard. If delta G naught is lesser than 0, then minus delta G naught divided by RT is positive, and e to the power minus delta G standard by RT is greater than 1, making K is greater than 1, which implies a spontaneous reaction or the reaction which proceeds in the forward direction to such an extent that the products are present predominantly. If delta G naught is greater than 0, then delta G standard by RT is negative and e to the power minus delta G naught by RT is lesser than 1. That is, K is lesser than 1, which implies a non-spontaneous reaction or a reaction which proceeds in the forward direction to such a small degree that only a very minute quantity of product is formed. Let's take one example. The value of delta G naught for the phosphorylation of glucose in glycolysis is 13.8 kilojoule per mole. Find the value of Kc at 298 Kelvin temperature. This can be solved as delta G naught is equal to 13.8 kilojoule per mole. That is 13.8 into 10 to the power 3 joule per mole. Also, delta G naught is equal to minus RT ln Kc. Hence, ln Kc is equal to 13.8 into 10 to the power 3 joule per mole into 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin and into 298 Kelvin temperature. So, ln Kc is equal to minus 5.569. So, Kc will be e to the power minus 5.569. So, the value of Kc will be 13.81 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now, the factors affecting equilibrium. A system in equilibrium is affected by the following factors. Change of concentration of any reactant or products, that is first. Second, change of temperature of the system. Third point, change of pressure on the system. And fourth, addition of catalyst. Fifth, addition of some inert gases. The effect of change of concentration, pressure, and temperature on equilibrium is predicted with the help of a principle known as Li Chatelier principle, described below. The effect of adding a catalyst on an inert gas, the addition of catalyst does not disturb the equilibrium. However, it helps in the attainment of equilibrium quickly. Now, about Li Chatelier's principle, if a system in equilibrium is subjected to change of concentration, temperature or pressure, the equilibrium shifts in a direction that tends to undo the effect of the change imposed is known as Li Chatelier principle. This is applicable to all physical and chemical equilibrium. Effect of concentration change. In general, when equilibrium is disturbed by addition or removal of any reactants or products, Li Chatelier principle predicts that the concentration stress of an added reactant or product is relieved by a net reaction in the direction that replenishes the removed substance. For example, H2 react with I2 gives twice of HI. If H2 is added to the reaction mixture at equilibrium, then the equilibrium of the reaction is disturbed. In order to restore it, the reaction proceeds in a direction where H2 is conserved. As more of H2 and I2 react to form HI, and finally the equilibrium shift in right forward direction. This is according to the Li Chatelier principle. Now, the second effect of catalyst. A catalyst increases the rate of chemical reaction by making available a new low energy pathway for the conversion of reactants to products. That is, it increases the rate of forward and reverse reactions that pass through the same transition state and does not affect equilibrium. Next, catalyst lowers the activation energy for the forward and reverse reactions by exactly the same amount. Catalyst does not affect the equilibrium composition of a reaction mixture. It does not appear in the balanced chemical equation or in the equilibrium constant expression. Let us consider manufacture of sulfuric acid by contact process. Twice of SO2 plus O2 in gaseous form react with each other to give twice of SO3. Here the oxidation of sulfur is taking place. Now the Kc for this reaction is 1.7 into 10 to the power 26. Though the value of K is suggestive of reaction going to completion, but practically oxidation of SO2 to SO3 is very slow. Thus, platinum or divanadium pentoxide, that is V2O5, is used as catalyst to increase the rate of reaction. Now, the third effect is effect of change of pressure. A pressure change obtained by changing the volume can affect the yield of products in case of a gaseous reaction where the total number of moles of gaseous products are different. In applying Li Chatelier's principle to a heterogeneous equilibrium, the effect of pressure change on solid and liquid can be ignored because the volume of a solution or liquid is nearly independent of pressure. For example, consider the reaction of N2O4 into NO2. N2O4 gives twice of NO2. Here, 1 mole of N2O4 form 2 moles of NO2. Here, the forward reaction occurs with increase in number of moles. Therefore, the backward reaction must proceed with decrease in number of moles. If now the pressure on the system is increased, then according to Li Chatelier's principle, the equilibrium will shift in a direction in which the pressure decrease or the number of moles decrease, because pressure is directly proportional to the number of moles. Fourth effect, effect of inert gas addition. If the volume is kept constant and an inert gas such as argon is added which does not take part in the reaction, the equilibrium remains undisturbed. It is because The addition of an inert gas at constant volume does not change the partial pressure or the molar concentration of the substance involved in the reaction. The reaction quotient Q changes only if the added gas is a reactant or product involved in the reaction. Now, the last effect is effect of temperature change. When a change in temperature occurs, the value of equilibrium constant, that is Kc, is changed. In general, the temperature dependent of the equilibrium constant depends on the sign of delta H. Here, delta H is change in enthalpy for the reaction. The equilibrium for an exothermic reaction is negative delta H decrease as the temperature increase. The equilibrium constant for an endothermic reaction, like positive delta H, increases as the temperature increase. Temperature changes affect the equilibrium constant and rates of a reaction. For example, production of ammonia according to the reaction N2 plus thrice of H2 gives twice of NH3. Delta H for this reaction is -92.38 kilojoule per mole, is an exothermic process. According to Li Chatelier's principle, rising the temperature shifts the equilibrium to left and decrease the equilibrium concentration of ammonia. In other words, low temperature is favorable for high yield of ammonia, but practically very low temperature slow down the reaction and thus a catalyst is used. So, in this lecture we have studied about the factors which affect the chemical equilibria. In the next lecture, we will discuss about ionic equilibrium in solutions, acid base and salts, and ionization of acids and bases. Thank you.